Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. We are back with another science scavenger hunt, where we take everyday materials and show you some science that's at work behind them. But instead of explaining that science and telling you how and why it works, we challenge you to hop online and see if you can find out the answer for yourself. It's a science scavenger hunt. And today, you're going to need an apple, you're going to need a pencil, and some kind of heavy spoon. In this case, I'm using my trusted, tried and true ice cream scooper. Now you're going to take the pencil and you're going to push it through the bottom of the apple until it comes out the top of the apple. And I want just enough of the pencil to be sticking out so I can grab a hold of it. Now here's the science. I'm going to take this and I'm going to tap it on something hard, in this case this railing. And I want you to watch what happens to the apple as I tap. Here we go. What you should have noticed is that the apple worked its way down the pencil when I tapped it. Now let's reverse it. I'm gonna slide the apple up a little bit so I can grab a hold of the bottom of the pencil. I'm gonna take my ice cream scooper and now I'm gonna hammer the top of my pencil. Watch what happens to the apple. That's pretty cool. As I hammered the top of the pencil, the apple actually made its way up the pencil. Now there's gotta be some really cool science at work here. Why, when I tapped the pencil, did my apple work its way down? And then when I tapped the top of the pencil, the apple came all the way up. That's your scavenger hunt for the day. What made the apple move up and down the pencil when I tapped it on different parts of the pencil? Jump online and see if you can find out the answer to this science scavenger hunt. I'll give you a hint. Maybe you want to check out some of our Fun Science Demo videos on our channel, Fun Science Demos, to see if you can find the answer. Here's the clue. Check out videos that deal with inertia. Then hop on some other science websites to see if you can find the answer. As always, post your answers in the comments below. Please don't forget to tell your friends and teachers about our science scavenger hunts. And maybe you want to grab an apple, a pencil, and a spoon and try this for yourself. Science really is all around you. Sometimes you just have to stop and try and wonder why. Thanks for watching. Happy hunting.